A couple of years ago, while we were away on one of our many adventures, our smaller chest freezer compressor failed, and we returned home a couple of weeks later to about 35 pounds of fermenting hamburger and several other items we had in our freezer. It stunk. We like to go on adventures, as you've seen in many of our adventures here on our channel. Sometimes we take our Tesla Model S, and other times we tow our solar-powered RV. During our camping adventures in the RV, I often reference the temperature as I review how well our mini split is working to heat or cool our trailer in varied circumstances. Whether we're at home or on trips, it's helpful to be able to see the temperatures in various locations, but I'm not always in all of those locations at the same time, so it would be really useful and helpful to be able to see these details over the internet. When YoLink offered to send me three of their X3 temperature and humidity monitoring devices, as well as two of their outdoor temperature sensors to review, I jumped on the opportunity to try out this awesome tech, which has amazing battery life, great wireless distance using the LoRa or long range wireless communication protocol, and the ability to log the data over time and even export that data. To be clear, YoLink simply sent me these devices and didn't dictate that I say anything in particular about these devices. We purchase half a cow at a time, and the last time that amounted to 258 pounds of meat, which cost us $1,059. Plus, we keep other things in our 20 cubic foot freezer, so if it had failed and we didn't intervene within a couple of days, we would lose over $1,000 worth of food. This device is cheap insurance to ensure we get a warning if the temperature increases inside our freezer, especially when we're away traveling. I also like to be able to track the outside weather in general, or use the humidity monitoring for use cases like measuring the effectiveness of the desiccant packets in the AMS of our 3D printer to ensure our filament remains dry. In order for the temperature sensors to connect to the internet and notify us remotely of an anomaly, they have to connect to a hub, which YoLink has two. There's the basic hub that connects via regular Wi-Fi or a hardwired Ethernet port, and they also have a speaker hub that connects only via Wi-Fi. To use the internet functionality, you do have to create a YoLink account, which is super basic, just asking for your email address, username, and password. They sent me the speaker hub, and I appreciate that they included the AC power adapter as well as the micro USB power cord. I wish it was USB-C, which is a much more convenient and robust port, but that's not a big deal in this case, as it's not going to be repeatedly unplugged like my cell phone, for instance. They included QR codes to the app in the Apple and Android app stores, which is convenient. Scanning the QR code on the bottom of the speaker hub was very simple, but connecting it to the Wi-Fi was more problematic. I kept getting this error stating that the phone was not yet connected to the device's hotspot. But after I disconnected from the Wi-Fi on the device, power cycled the YoLink hub, then reconnected it to the Wi-Fi, I was then presented with this prompt of whether I wanted to connect to the Wi-Fi network despite it not being connected to the internet. Then I was able to proceed with the setup, which was done for the hub at that point. The X3 temperature sensors come with thorough instructions, but it was simple enough I didn't really need to reference them. Adding the additional devices was as simple as tapping the Add Device button in the mobile app and scanning the QR code on the device. All the temperature devices come with two AA batteries to get you started. After it was added to the mobile app, I was immediately able to see the temperature and humidity, and I was able to go into that device in the app and configure it to the settings I wanted, such as Fahrenheit versus Celsius, and how often to record the temperature and humidity, from every 10 minutes up to every 60 minutes. It lets you download the logs for up to the last 6 months, which I'm certainly going to be taking advantage of in various experiments. Plus, I'm going to be putting one in my RV while we're camping, and I'll be able to track the temperature there. In fact, I'll also do a test putting one in the front and rear of the trailer to see what the temperature difference is, since our mini split is in the front of the trailer, and I want to know how much hotter or colder it gets in the very back where the kids sleep. I now have all five of the devices turned on and connected to my account, and they are all displayed here on this screen. As you can see, we have the downstairs freezer, which is an upright freezer, and it's showing 1.8 degrees Fahrenheit, which is perfect. I want it to be right around 0 degrees Fahrenheit, and I'm sure that temperature will fluctuate slightly. And you can see here that initially it was on for a while at 75 about degrees in my office, and then it dropped down as I put it in the freezer, of course, and the humidity just dropped off precipitously. And then if we go back, we have the upstairs freezer, and this also is close to 0 degrees, although I think it is still adjusting. We'll see what it does long term. And you can see that the temperature dropped off as I put it in there. Same with humidity. So this is the X3 sensor in the RV that shows the temperature at 57 degrees and the humidity at 39 degrees. So it didn't drop off as precipitously because it's, well, not as cold out there, of course. And then we have the two outdoor sensors. These are the two at the bottom. So we have the outdoor temperature at home. I just simply put this on the north side of our house, just outside, and I made sure the probe wasn't touching anything. So this is just the ambient temperature outside. And this does not show the humidity, of course, it's just the temperature. And so I had it here in my office at about 75, 76 degrees, and then took it outside, and now it's really quickly registering the lower temperature outside at 41.2 degrees. And then lastly, we have the refrigerator in the kitchen showing 39.4 degrees, and I just put it in there a little bit ago, but it looks like it has leveled out. And so I'll keep my eye on this and potentially use this to more accurately adjust my ideal temperature that I want my refrigerator to be. It does allow you to add additional rooms. So you can see up here, I've added a kitchen with the refrigerator in it. I haven't really bothered to add any other rooms at this point, and I don't have enough devices to probably justify that level of configuration, but I can see that if you had a lot of devices, that would be very helpful. I can go in here to my settings. I can administer my rooms right here, and I can add or remove or rename them. Alarm strategies allows me to say, hey, you know, this is how I want to be notified via the alarm. And so if I go in here to always, for instance, they're all on already, but I can say how I want to be notified via either the app or email. And if you go into email, then of course you can specify a do not disturb time frame, or you can turn it on or off this alarm, etc. There's a lot of different settings in here that are helpful to be able to fine-tune how you want to use these devices, what their setting that they're used in, your temperature range of the warnings. So like if I go to my upstairs freezer as an example, I can go in here to the alert right here. Here you can see I have the low and set to unlimited, but to notify me if it's above 20 degrees Fahrenheit. Now I noticed that on this slider, it is a little tricky to get exactly what you want. So getting exactly on 20.0 is difficult, so 20.1 is close enough. And then I can alarm on the humidity as well, which in my case, I don't really care what the humidity is. And then we have an alert interval down here, which is, you know, how often it's going to be checking and then alerting you. And I'll just leave that off, so it'll just notify me the moment it sees anything amiss. But overall, I'm very happy with all of these devices and this app and the interface of it and the customizability. I will potentially be picking up some additional sensors to use for different purposes. I've now had the YoLink devices running for over 24 hours, and so I thought I'd show you what the graphs look like. So if we go in here to the downstairs freezer, this shows the last 24 hours of the temperature fluctuations as well as the humidity. And you'll see a corresponding drop in humidity when the temperature drops down, because that's when the compressor kicks on and pulls out some of that humidity. And I think throughout most of this, we haven't opened this freezer at all. If we go over here to more and go to weekly, this is only the last like day and a half or 2 days since I installed the device. You'll see on the left side that there's this huge drop in temperature, and that's because I unboxed it in my office and then put it into the freezer. But basically, if we touch on this, you can see that the temperature gets down to about negative 10 degrees and then goes up as high as about 5 degrees Fahrenheit and then back down to negative. And that's just bouncing up and down as the compressor turns on and off. There's a little blip here. I'm not really sure why that's different. And it continues. And then the humidity over here as well. And frankly, the humidity is higher than I would have expected in the 40s and 50s. I'm not sure if the accuracy of the humidity is affected by the low temperatures, however. If we go over here to the upstairs freezer, we can see similar pattern in that it's going up and down, but what's interesting to me is it's a different variance. It's actually much closer. This is getting as low as about negative 5 degrees, and then it peaks up about negative 3, and so it's actually staying colder than the other one, and it's just the compressor is cycling more frequently, just the way it's programmed, I guess. And then this is a point where somebody got something out of that freezer, so it got as high as 1.2 degrees Fahrenheit and then dropped back down as the compressor pulled it down. So that's kind of interesting. And then you can see a corresponding increase right here of humidity when the freezer was opened. It let in a lot of humidity from the house, of course, so it jumped up to 62%, and then it took a couple of cycles for it to get pulled back down. And then if we go over here to the RV, this is kind of interesting. You'll see just that there's this kind of a slow sine wave, and if I go to more and look at weekly, you'll see that the temperature of the RV does increase and decrease with the days and the nights. And looks like the first night it got down to as low as 28.4 degrees in the trailer, and then as high as 48, almost 49 degrees the next day. And that's just kind of the cycle that it is on. The humidity is staying somewhat regular, but interestingly dropped here as it got warmer in the middle of the next day. If we go over here to the temperature that's just outside of our house, and you can see an obvious corresponding, daytime highs and then nighttime lows temperature, and that it got down to as low as 25 degrees Fahrenheit in this case for us. And you'll notice that it's 7:37 in the morning that it gets that low, because that's when the sun is rising and that's the coldest that it gets before it then ramps back up. And if we go over here to the weekly, we can see that daily swing in temperatures once again. And then lastly, if we go up here to the refrigerator, you'll see that the similar to the freezers, it just is the compressor is cycling on and off, and it's bouncing between 39 and let's see, about 37 degrees. However, you'll see these spikes up here, and that's when somebody's opening the freezer and getting things out of it. In fact, if we go over here to more and the weekly, you'll see it actually shows a little bit more normalized data, but you'll see that there are spikes here during the middle of the day, but throughout the night, it's actually more consistently low because obviously we're not opening the freezer. So there's two nights of data right here. So I just thought I'd share this data insight that you can get out of these and see trended temperature and humidity data, at least the humidity out of the sensors that have it across all of these. And we could have a lot more sensors here and we could see the data for all of them. And I'm a data person, so I think this is really interesting and potentially informative depending on what I'm using it for.
YoLink is based out of Irvine, California, and they have a broad offering of devices such as a water leak protection sensor, valve controllers, water level sensor, which would have been helpful in our case for our chicken water bucket, or any variety of water storage purposes. They have motion detectors, garage door controllers, sensors for whether your window or door is open, glass break sensors, smoke sensors, sirens, smart locks, thermostats, generic smart switches, smart plugs for power monitoring and control, smart power strips, smart outdoor power strips, etc., etc. Their LoRa protocol they use can transmit up to 1,320 feet, or 400 meters, when there is a clear line of sight between the hub and the device. Otherwise, it still transmits really far, even when the device is inside a metal box like our fridge and freezer. I really like that it logs the temperature and data, and that it has an export function to be able to download that data. If the hub loses access to the internet, the X3 temperature device will continue to store the data internally in offline mode, and it can store up to 60,000 events. The battery life can last up to 2 years in the X3 temperature sensor. I'll put a link to their website in the description below, and I recommend checking out all of their many devices that they have to offer. I'm going to continue to use these devices, and they'll undoubtedly show up in future videos. I might make a follow-up video once I have data to report regarding their performance over a long period of time. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video.